So last night, Keemstar made this tweet that says, Pokimane 2 out of 10. Now, when I first saw this, I didn't really think much of it. Obviously, it's a dick move. It's something I would never tweet, but it's pretty par for the course in terms of what Keemstar tweets on his timeline. It's super common for him to take jabs at creators he doesn't like, and because it's so common, most people don't bat an eye when it happens. But for some reason, this one broke the mold to the point where it actually got Keemstar and Pokimane trending on Twitter. So, let's see why this was the case, and what people's reactions to it were. 100 Thieves Frost responds to Keemstar by saying, "What was the point of tweeting this dog?" Then Keemstar replies with a banner of a tweet Frost made that says, "Sex is temporary, gaming is forever." Lil Timmy then responds, "You are comparing an ironic, lighthearted, fun Frost tweet with cyberbullying. Lol, okay." Keemstar responds, "Cyberbullying? Do you still sleep with the nightlight on?" To which Timmy responds, "Come on, Keem. The 2 out of 10 Poke tweet was unprompted and not tasteful. Not hard to see that it's not being productive or positive in any way. Don't be part of the toxic community around bullying streamers with your platform. That has so much potential to do so much better." Esports Law responds to Keemstar's tweet by saying, "Here's the thing. You think you are being edgy, but you are actually being a misogynistic piece of garbage. If the entire point of your tweet is to tear someone down, start over." Keemstar replies, "I'm gonna be honest. You sound like a complete fucking dork." Esports Law replies, "If this makes me a complete fucking dork, I'm good with it. 2.8 million people are following you, and the example you are setting for them is pretty tragic. Maybe you should try to be a dork instead of weaponizing your fanbase to attack someone." Keemstar quote tweets him and says, "This grown-ass man thinks me rating Pokey is weaponizing my fanbase. You can't make this shit up." Over the last 24 hours, I've had the most ridiculous reactions from these clowns. I'm going to drop a video on all of them. FaZe Ewok responds to Keemstar by saying, "Delete this." Ryan Watt also says, "Delete this," to which Keemstar responds, "No." Dino Nuggets responds to Keem by saying, "I don't think Pokimane cares about your opinion or her looks." To which 0987 responds, "Trust me, she does. She can't handle criticism. Lol." Dicey's responds to Keem by saying, "You are the most toxic creator out there. All you do is break down others," shaking my head. Shameless plug if you enjoy Minecraft PvP content. Foss Key responds, "Who the fuck are you to talk about a powerful woman like that? Learn some respect." Ollie responds, "Because she steals a living off people simping her." Landon responds to Keem by saying, "Why tweet this, Keem? Sad." To which Toei responds, "Pokimane takes no criticism and plays victim in many scenarios when she deserves criticism. She is pretty hot, but that does not excuse the things she's said and done." Brittany Venti responds to Keem by saying, "Would not watch again." To which Alexi responds, "Haha, let's belittle other women because she gets attention from men, and I don't like the game she plays. Hahaha! Yes, please men, like my post, I beg of you." Brittany Venti responds, "Poki panders to men as a girlfriend simulator for a living. And you were really about to implicate that I am the one who's a pick-me here?" Brittany Venti then quote tweets Keem and says, "It's not shocking when a man rates a woman's value based on what she made her entire career on. It's not about her being attractive. It's about her being uninteresting and basing her entire career to pander to simps playing girlfriend simulator. Play superficial games, get shallow responses." A Pokimane stan account called Tommy Space Buns replies to Keemstar by saying, "Keemstar, 1 billion out of 10. Santos then replies, "That's crazy, but isn't this you?" Showing a picture of some guy wearing a shirt that says, "I love Poki." Greek God X responds by showing a short picture of Keemstar and saying, "Keemstar, 5'2". To which Keemstar responds, "You are fake news." Showing that Greek God X is indeed not a Greek god. Bamboni quote tweets Keem and says, "Posting my rating of a woman on the internet, completely unprovoked at my ripe age of 47. Oak Tree responds to Keem by saying, "Keemstar, attacks creators for no reason. Racist. Makes fake news claims that ruin people's lives. Promoted child porn. Swats people. Plays the victim. Keemstar, 0 out of 10. Twoon responds to Keem by saying, "Bro, fucking hell, man. Didn't have to be so nice to her. A 0.5 out of 10 at best. IBS Rights responds to Keem by saying, "You talk mad shit for a garden gnome. Sydney says, how does it feel knowing the only way you can make money is by saying stuff like this? Night Blue responds to Keem by saying, imagine being a 38-year-old man and still acting like you just got home from middle school. What a cringe human being. Twoon quote tweets him and says, it's so fucking cringy seeing these actual simps defend every single thing said about Pokimane, even when Keemstar was obviously trying to bait them out. Bro, we get it. You wanna fuck her. She's not the perfect queen you think she is, and that is 100% fine. Keemstar quote tweets Night Blue and says, your profile picture says it all, Mr. 3-tier sub. C9 Kala responds to Keem by saying, buddy, you're a goof, to which Keem responds, tier 3 sub spotted. Liv Bevan responds to Keem by saying, imagine using your platform to publicly judge and tear down women. What a horrible example you set. Would you want your daughter to be subjected to the same? Lord Richard responds, I could probably list down 5 women who use their platform to tear down men, but y'all only woke when it fits the virtue signaling checklist. Liv responds, yeah, and that's wrong too. And I have absolutely no insight into whatever his beef with Pokimane is. However, my point was is that women having their worth boiled down to a rating to be publicly humiliated or ridiculed is wrong no matter what way you look at it. Gibby responds to Keem by saying, your attention-seeking methods are by far the saddest thing I've seen on the internet. I know you only do this for engagement, but fuck off. Keemstar responds, your attention-seeking methods are by far the saddest thing I've seen on the internet. I know you only do this for engagement, but fuck off. Grosscore responds to Keem with a Twitter video captioned, right, now I'm pissed off.
Hey, why are people fucking taking the bait? He's clearly baiting all you fucking people replying with hate and defending Pokimane. He's trolling you. Keemstar would die to fucking get close to Pokimane and sit and hold a hand. He's clearly trolling. He's clearly joking. No one give this guy a reaction. Everyone stop complaining and defending Pokimane because he's joking. It's the fucking Keemstar, mate. No drama on his shitty little channel, so he needs to whoop up drama for himself. So he's got to attack those popular fucking girl person who is on the internet. So fucking start and stop giving this guy attention. Fuck this.
Daniel responds to Keem by saying, this man has a whole ass daughter at home. What a great example to set for her, Keem. Mr. Gravy says, what an absolutely pathetic misogynistic asshole. Keemstar then responds with a picture of him in a diva costume from Overwatch and says, is this you? He responds by saying, this guy took my pinned tweet and thought I'd be self-conscious about it. Keemstar replies, sir, you are brave. To which McGravy responds, nah, it doesn't take any bravery to talk on the internet. If I'm brave, then you're a good father figure. And we all know that's not true. Oh my god, damn. Keemstar quote tweets him and says, another tier 3 sub attacks my daughter, lol. My child is winning awards in dance, sports, and science. She's 11 and making her own income as an online entertainer without any of my help promotion-wise. My kid will go much farther in life than all of you pathetic losers. Poutine responds to Keem's original tweet by saying, I've supported you through thick and thin, Keemstar, but this is a step too far. I can forgive you for your racist rant on battle cams. I can forgive you for the mistaken pedo allegations, but this, I cannot. I'm sorry, Keem. Brittany Venti screenshots his response and says, apparently insulting Pokimane is where simps draw the line. Hard to tell what's real or satire anymore. Poutine then quote tweets her and says, why am I being attacked for standing up for what's right? Hashtag PokeSquad. Valkyrie responds to Keemstar's tweet by saying, this tweet fucking sucks and is completely unnecessary. Lily Pichu responds, agreed. To which Keemstar replies, this tweet fucking sucks and is completely unnecessary. Romeo then replies, it's funny seeing a grown-ass man do this type of stuff. iPurple responds to him by saying, if only you gave your daughter the same amount of attention you put into tearing down others on the internet. You might be a decent father figure. Cryptic No responds, to which iPurple responds with confirmation that he got blocked by Keem. It's Waddles then takes these responses and says, I just witnessed murder on the timeline. Pokimane ended up liking this tweet. It's the only tweet she liked out of the entire situation. Amber responds to Lily Pichu's agreed tweet by saying, how about help your friend take real criticism and jokes instead of bringing your simps here? Lily responds, what does attacking one's appearance have to do with helping your friend take real criticism? Let's be honest here. Most people, including you, don't have any real interest in actually helping her. Amber responds, Keem has literally been a troll on Twitter for the longest time. It's not his first time going at Pokey. And he said firstly 2 out of 10. How do you know that was at her looks? Let's be honest. How am I supposed to help someone from my position? You are the friend, not me. Your job, not mine. Lily responds, it was clearly a jab at her looks. And you are right. You can't help her from your position. So your tweet wasn't the kindest, the accusation of me not helping my friend, of bringing up my simps? What? Please strive to be more empathetic to one another in the future. Amber responds, fair. I shouldn't have said it like that. I said simps because I feel one can't say anything without immediately being flamed and attacked by their followers. The rating I thought was based on general likeness, since nothing else was said from what I can see. Lily responds, I don't really condone attacking anyone for their opinion. It's impossible to control everyone on the internet, especially if you have a large audience. That goes for me, Keem, whoever. I've got nothing against you. I just hope we can all be a little kinder. Have a nice day. Starkiller reacts to the interaction between Valkyrie and Keemstar by saying, laughing my ass off. He's like an evil version of Michael Scott. Also, it's funny how you guys think I'm pissed off whenever I repost something like this. I am honestly cracking up at how fucking stupid he is. I know how Keem built his name, but I just don't find his trolling funny. H3 makes a comment about this by showing the tweet Keemstar made and then a picture of Keemstar and saying, imagine calling someone ugly when you look like this. Brittany Venti responds, don't you have a wife to simp for? I'm just saying, if this were my husband going around fighting people over a girl being called ugly, I wouldn't be happy. Keep your own wife. Keemstar quote tweets himself and then says, I'm being attacked by virgins. This is fun. You should try it too. Pokimane simps. Showing a picture of four blind guys. So for anybody who had the theory that Keemstar was not talking about Pokimane's looks, I mean, here's the proof if you needed any. But then he did delete those tweets and replaced it with this quote tweet that says, oops, I was way off. Her birthday is May 14th, not February 10th. Starkiller reacts to this by saying, I legit hear him giggling whenever he does the Keem slide. By the way, if the Keem slide meme ever takes off, remember, I'm the one who labeled it. Ethan Klein responds to him by saying, Keemstar continuing to attack unobtainable women? To which Starkiller responds, I never said anything about her looks. I was talking about her birthday. What's wrong with that? Keemstar. Keemstar continues to meme about the situation on his timeline by tweeting out, Keemstar, 10 out of 10. Poke tier 3 subs are probably the most toxic people on the internet. JK Sad responds to him by saying, pretty cringe to see a 38-year-old man trying to stay relevant by pandering to edgy kids. I don't even mean to say this as an insult. It's just genuinely sad. Hope it gets better, man. Colin responds to him by saying, once again, no one asked. You drive so much of the toxicity in the gaming community. And I hope this recent breakdown over insecurities that females can do well as content creators marks the end of your career. Dude, imagine if after all the controversy Keemstar's been in, this is the thing that ends his career. Calling Pokimane 2 out of 10. I mean, it would be stupid as hell, but it would kind of be funny. Anyways, the greatest response to this tweet by saying, getting offended by something posted on the internet is like choosing to step on dog shit instead of walking around it. Bacho responds to Keem by saying, no man, I think it's you. Randomly calling people ugly is kind of toxic, not gonna lie. Pimpmaster Yoda responds to him by saying, I don't know about that one, Chief. It's gotta be at least 10 times a week that I view the trending topics on Twitter and see K-pop stans attempting to cancel someone. Illinois' actor responds to Keem by saying, wrong. Wrong on so many levels. Keem then screenshots this and says, we got another one, boys. My tweets are like a simp trap. Busted. Keemstar then makes a Twitter video about the entire situation titled, Weirdos.
Man, there are some straight up weirdos on the internet. Straight up weirdos. Over the last 24 hours, I've been getting this criticism of people saying that I'm a bad role model, that I'm setting a bad example for my followers and all this type of stuff. And I understand that for many people, like in gaming entertainment and online entertainment, they view themselves as role models. They view themselves as out there showing people how to be the right thing and do the right thing and set a good example. I understand all that. That's totally fine. But this isn't church, okay? This is online entertainment, right? My objective is just to be entertaining, right? I want those kids, when they go to Twitter who are bored, I want them to go to my feed, and find something entertaining to read or to talk about or to have an opinion, right? That is my objective as a person in online entertainment. Your objective can go out there to be, you know, the the teacher's pet. Your objective can be, you know, the Pope or whatever you're trying to be, you know, this big good guy figure that you're putting out there. That's all fine. But you live in a box. I don't live in your fucking box. I live in my own goddamn world. My own world is pretty dope. So go fuck yourself.
Jake Lucky responds to Keem's video by saying, "Hi, I'm a grown man with wife and daughter, and I want to rate Twitch streamers out of 10, hehehe. I not weirdo," Keemstar responds. And there we go, Jake getting another story wrong. Embarrassing, Lucas responds. "He actually just gave you a perfect description of what you are. The fact that you can't even realize it, so dangerous. I hope the mother to that daughter can make sure she comes out with none of your traits. You are the kind of people that make the world what it is. A toxic place." X Overrated responds to Keem by saying, "You want to entertain people, but the only people being entertained are incels. Nice job, old man." Keemstar quote tweets this and says, "It's a proven fact that my followers get more pussy than 3-tier subs." Mersalin responds, "Joke's on you. I'm gay." Keemstar responds, "Or dick." Someone replies to him by saying, "I just lost my virginity yesterday. Thank you, Keemstar." Keemstar quote tweets him and says, "No problem, I hope you wore a mask. Hashtag role model Keem." Jack Mayoff says, "Why does Keemstar have a platform? He fucking sucks." Keemstar quote tweets him and says, "Simp detector is going off." Geek Chick TV says, "Keemstar is saying Pokimane is 2 out of 10. Meanwhile, he's out here being George of Fraggle Rock looking ass." After all of this discussion, Ricky Berwick announces what he rates Pokimane in this Twitter video.
"I rate Pokimane a 10 out of 10. Come here, babe."
Optimus responds to him by saying, "Alright, dog, no cap. Did not expect the pants to drop." Ricky responds with a wink emoji. Keemstar then tweets out, "Keemstar and Keem fans, 10,000. Poke tier 3 subs, 0. This guy is in my DMs threatening to beat me up." Once again, showing that picture of the guy wearing the I Love Poke shirt. "This tier 3 sub is spamming his lame joke at me over and over. She's not gonna fuck you, dude. How does it feel that Keemstar gave you more attention than your queen ever will?" Showing that someone named Necky keeps posting under his tweets. "This fool Keemstar after he shaves that raggedy ass beard of his off." Showing a picture of Dr. Eggman at the end of the Sonic the Hedgehog movie. That's a great movie, you should check it out. I love it a lot. Anyways, Keemstar apologizes for all of this in a video titled, "I'm Sorry."
As you guys know, there has been a certain female online entertainer's fan base that has been attacking me. And I would like to make a response to all of them right now. This is my official statement.
Keemstar then points out that JoJo Siwa liked his tweet and says, "Legend." Leafy responds to him by saying, "W." Keemstar then posted this meme of him saying, "Haha, Pokey 2 out of 10. And then someone responding, "No, you can't rate my queen 2 out of 10. Oh, so sad. Now, Pokimane never ended up responding to this controversy, but she did pseudo-respond in a way by retweeting what one of her friends had to say about the situation. Her name is Bree Bun, and she says, "It feels surreal watching an entire community mourn the loss of a creator, start to encourage anti-bullying sentiments online, but then slowly go back to bullying publicly for like/drama-mongering. It feels like mental health is only taken seriously when it's already too late. I just hate seeing it. There is no time like the present to start treating people with kindness and consider their mental well-being before we hit send. We should always try to put ourselves in someone else's shoes and consider what they might be going through." Lily Pichu responds to her by saying, "This makes me sad." To which Bree Bun responds, "Me too. So much. It's absolutely heart-wrenching. That's a pretty interesting sentiment. I don't feel the same way." Despite Keem's tweet being something that I wouldn't post and an asshole thing to do, I just think the entire reaction to all of this is valid, but also overblown at the same time. But that's just my opinion. I would love to hear what you guys have to say in the comments section below. If you want to keep up to date with all the drama, be sure to subscribe with notifications on. Follow me on Twitter to keep up to date with stuff in real time, and follow me on StoryFire to get videos early. Thank you so much to my channel members for supporting the channel, in particular Alexis, Mr. Personality, The Dank Memes Plays, Astemic, and Pescator for $30 a month, Ruby Box Fox for $40 a month, and Boar for $50 a month. Your donations mean a lot to me. It helps my channel immensely. But with all that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.